it does alter the way that the Chinese are viewing the U.S. president and his negotiating position. They see the U.S. president under impeachment threat as being slightly weaker and in a weaker negotiating position, which will make Beijing even less likely to come to the table with any fundamental concessions that the White House says is necessary for a deal to be realized. But interestingly, on the U.S. side, even as some of President Trump's advisors become even more hardline with China, the political risks that come with impeachment may make him more ready to agree to some kind of modest arrangement, certainly not a comprehensive trade deal, but a small mini deal, perhaps in the October talks, in part because he knows he needs to keep Senate Republicans on his side so that he is not voted out of office when the House votes to impeach him, a probability that the Eurasia Group puts at about 75%. So he knows he needs those Senate Republicans on his side. And those Republicans have told him that they're concerned about distressed farmers, they're concerned about deflating U.S. manufacturing activity, and they're telling the president that they need him to come to some sort of agreement with China to at least avert onward escalation of tariffs.
Do you handicap it for me, Meredith, if you would? Is it your base case that the tariffs that the president has proposed and kind of put on hold for now ultimately will go into effect come mid-October after the Chinese delegation is here, or that there will be some, again, another pause because China agrees, for example, let's say, to buy more soybeans or corn?
Exactly. Well, the case for impeachment is underscoring our 40% probability, which is our base case, that the White House will agree to some kind of mini deal with China in October. But this is really predicated upon a couple of things here. One, the president needs to feel that impeachment risk and to move on it and find ways to delay the onward tariff escalation. But second, White House officials have been clear that they are expecting Liu He, this is the Chinese vice premier and negotiator, they're expecting him to come to the table next week in Washington with something substantially more than what the Chinese came to the table with in September, which was the offering did not impress the U.S. counterparts. And so they're looking for a little bit more on the Chinese side. The key question here is, following the impeachment moves, as well as following the October 1st, 70th anniversary of the People's Republic of China, which is tomorrow, will that give Xi Jinping and the Chinese more space to allow Liu He to come to the table with a slightly sweeter offer?
Meredith, real quickly on that, if we get there's two kind of possibilities for that anniversary. The one is that we see a big increase in violence. The other, I suppose, is that doesn't necessarily happen. The protests still continue. The status quo continues. And explain how either outcome might change the Chinese strategy here with regard to the U.S.
Certainly. Well, tomorrow is going to be a flashpoint of protests in Hong Kong. There are a mix of protests that are planned around Hong Kong. We have a base case, low probability of 25%. That Beijing will use some kind of intervention, probably more so a people arms police intervention than a military intervention, to try to bring some kind of order in Hong Kong. Tomorrow could be a flashpoint, in part because the political significance of that date could step up the moves by protesters and the moves by Hong Kong police to suppress those protesters. Over the longer term, though, what will affect Beijing's calculation on that front is less the U.S. trade negotiation, that certainly is front of mind for President Xi, but he is more so concerned about what any kind of military intervention in Hong Kong would do for the prospects of the election of Tsai Ing-wen as the next Taiwan, as Taiwan's president in January. So those January 2020 elections are what Beijing is more so concerned about.